Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today we will install an IDE for programming in C language. We will install a compiler and also we will test our first program. The IDE that we are going to use will be Eclipse. For that we will go to Google, search for Eclipse. First link, download. 64-bit version, download and save file. I have copied the file on my desktop. Double click on it from where it's downloaded. Double click on the installer. Then choose the IDE for C, C++ developers. Select a path. Okay, I agree with the paths. Accept. Remember, accept the license. Okay, at this moment, do you trust these certificates? We will trust them because they are from Eclipse. Always accept. And that's it. We will close this installer. Routex installer, launch installer. No. Because we have to install the compiler. For the compiler, you shall go to the Google again and search for minjw. And look for a download. Okay, we found it. Save the file two times, one time we can close it and execute the setup. Close the browser, install, accept, I accept the location. Okay, now this minjw is installing on our machine. It seems that it has finished. Continue. Installation. Not now. All packages. We are searching for a GNU compiler. Okay, we found one. We take the latest version, mark for installation. Now click installation, apply changes, apply. So now the compiler will be downloaded and it will be installed. All changes were applied successfully. Close, installation, quit. Now we can start Eclipse. For that we go to this PC. And I have installed mine under users. So for that I'll go to C drive, users, my user, and I find it here. I don't want to move. I want to send a shortcut to the desktop. Okay, I have these two shortcuts. This installer, I can get rid of it. So, okay, let's open Eclipse now. Select a workspace. Let's say I want to be on D. Okay, now the Eclipse has opened. We exit the workbench here. And this is it. From this icon right here, you can open different perspectives. So we are in the C, C++ perspective. So we are okay with that. Let's test our first program. File, new project, C, C++, C project, next, min.jw that we have installed. Give it a project name, hello world, next, we only want the debug, executable, finish. Our project will appear in the project explorer on the left pane. Okay, these are the include files from min.jw. We will create one source file for us. So we will give it a name, lesson01.c. It's very important to put the extension of the file. Now, what template? Default C source. Okay, finish. Okay. It generates a header with the name of the file, the date when this file was created, and the author, that is the username of the Windows. So now we can start test our compiler and linker to see if they really work. So now we will write the Hello World program. Include less than greater than a standard input output library. Okay, also we'll put a comment inside. Okay. Now we'll create the main function. Its declaration is of type int. We will say that it takes no arguments. We will write the hello world sentence. We will return 0, 0. Save, build with this hammer right here and launch. Okay, so nothing happens for the moment.
We have to run the program first time from this run option menu. Next, let's see what version of C standard our compiler uses. For that, we shall print a long integer to our console and we put inside a compiler variable, stdc version build. Okay, this appears. So 2017, so this means C18 standard. If we have requirements to use a lower standard, we can do that from our project. Properties, C, C++ build, settings, GCC compiler. We go to this tab right here and we put inside std equal C11, for example. Apply. Build again the project. Run. So now it's 2011. So this is C11 standard. And you can also do this for the other standards. Okay, so that's all for this video. We'll continue Forger in the next video. Bye. If you like the video, give it a like and consider subscribing to my channel.